Yo, what's good, fam? So today I wanna make a Rasta type beat. You know, it might not be like a legit artist that like have an album, EP or whatever, but he dropped some fire beats lately, so I'm gonna try and make his type shit. So enjoy this video and hit the like button. I wanna try. Let's try and hit like 10 likes on this video. Subscribe. Enjoyed the video. Let's get to it. So I'll start with the bass line. And GMS is a good plugin for bass line. You can use analog bass. So that's our baseline. I want to EQ the high end. I got it because it's a bass. Let's pull it to mono. Let's use GTG ST2008. It's a free plugin. I have the link to that in the description. So I want to use a sound. It's called Atmo Piano. I really like this sound. So that's our melody. Let's take it to the mixer. Which one? Okay, let's take it to track 3. Let's cut off the low end. We don't need that. Let's make it stereo wide. Got the stereo shape here. So you can have it stereo wide while panning left and right. Can do this using Fruity Formula Controller. Go to preset LFO, basic design LFO. So you can adjust these knobs to like adjust the length of the panning, the speed, whatever. No, I just use this knob, make it at 75%. So you can control like the limit of it, how far it goes. Then you go to the panning knob, link to controller. Basic sign LFO accept, and you have something like that. And of course, I'm gonna add a reverb on it. Let's make it stereo. Pull on the bass. A little bit of high cut. A little bit of decay. Okay, let's layer our drums. So I want to start with a kick. Gonna go to 21 Savage drum kit. Let's choose a kick. Bad guy kick is a good kick. Yeah, let's layer it down. Let's use a snare. That's a bad snare. Can use this one. Resample. None. No loop points needed. That sounds good. Let's use an open hat. Open hat. Good one. Lower that sound. So I want to put it on the two. Just listen. The channel mixer and use stereo shaper to make it vibe a little bit of reverb. Layer the hi-hat. So writing a song like very fast hi-hats, like really fast. So we can play with the velocity of the bit. Make it go up and down all over the place. So we have something like that. Some air weights too, but you have to be careful with that because you have the baseline and on a layer. Anyway, I'll show you how you can manipulate it and like control it. So first you want to tune your 808, go to edit, Edison, detect pitch region. So this one is in A sharp. Go to A sharp. And now we have a tune. Then I like to go to the envelope, pull down all these controllers, pull up the hold all the way. So when you push a key, it will go all the way until you leave it or pull up the key. So let's take the channel mixer. Mixer channel, wherever. Pull down the high frequency. Then put the compressor on that. Gonna lower the threshold. And I'm gonna lower the ratio until the volume goes all the way up. You know. Sorry for that. Now I can adjust my threshold. So that's a good place. I'm just gonna layer the kick with the 808. And I'm gonna adjust the length of the note. So now what you want to do to make it even more clean, you can go to the baseline and the 808, just cut itself, like let's see, okay, we have on the 808 we have it cut itself 7x7, so you can go to the base and make it 7x7. So that they don't have a clash when like they hit at the same time. So let's take a listen. Okay, so I'm gonna arrange this real quick and just take a listen. Okay, guys, let's take a listen to this shit. so that's the beat right there. It's not perfect, but you got the idea, and I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Let me know in the comment section your feedback, what should I do next, and until next time, fam, peace.